Hello everyone. We've got a visitor here today. Have you seen him anywhere? He's big. He's very big. He's George the giant dump truck. Oh, there you are, George. George is usually hard at work in the mine, carrying massive amounts of rock. But today, he's here at Gecko's garage getting some new tyres fitted. They are huge. George is so big, he can't fit inside the garage. So he's having his tyres changed outside. Those look great. Well done, mechanicals. Before he goes home to the mine, George is going to visit his little brother, Dylan the dump truck, over at the construction site. The site entrance is wide, but George is much wider. Uh-oh, he's going to knock down the fence. Watch out, George! Oh dear. Florence and Sid are getting the flowers ready to plant in the gardens of the new houses. What pretty flowers! Red, yellow, and blue. Don't leave the flowers there. Those flowers are tall, but George is much taller. Uh-oh, George can't see the flowers and he's going to squash them. Watch out, George! Oh dear. Celia's pouring concrete foundations into that trench. The trench is large, but George is much larger. Uh-oh. He's going to drive straight through it. Watch out, George! Oh dear. Here's George's brother, Dylan. He doesn't look very happy about all the mess that George has made today. And here comes Helen the helicopter. She's checking on the construction work from way high up in the sky. Oh dear, something's wrong. I think Helen's about to crash land on the construction site. Oh dear, poor Helen. We need to get you back to the garage. But how can we do that? I'd normally call Helen to carry a broken vehicle to the garage, but she can't carry herself. Helen is very big. Can you think of anyone that could help get Helen to the garage? George! That's right! Helen is very big, but George is much bigger. He can carry Helen back. George is too big for gardening, and he smashed the construction gate. He messed up Celia's concrete. That really wasn't great. But when Helen was in trouble, he knew just what to do. No matter if you're big or small, there's a perfect job for you. It's my day off today. No vehicles to fix, and nothing to do but enjoy the sunshine at the beach. The only thing that could make this better is a delicious ice cream. Where did you get those from, Mechanicals? Vicky! Great to see you! One ice cream, please, with sprinkles and a flake. Oh no! Vicky's lost power to her ice cream churn and freezer. That means she can't stir the mixture or freeze it. Hmm. It looks like a problem with Vicky's generator. The generator creates electricity to power the churn and the freezer. We need replacement parts from the garage. But by the time we get there, all her ice cream will have melted. And just look at this queue of mechanicals waiting for ice cream. First, we need a way to churn up this ice cream mixture. Some kind of mixer. I think I've got an idea. Everyone, stop what you are doing. This is an emergency. Celia, Rick, mechanicals, come with me. The mechanicals are helping out, so there's no need to feel glum. They'll pump Vicky's ice cream mixture into Celia's mixing drum. Celia churns the ice cream mixture around and around and around. And now it's ready. And oh no, it's pouring on the ground! Rick, what are you doing? That's not fresh tarmac. It's supposed to be a chilly and delicious ice cream snack. Of course it isn't working right. Now I know the reason. Celia is doing the mixing, but the mixture isn't freezing. To go and find another freezer might take hours and hours. So let's all call for Super Mech with his super powers. Go, go, Super Mechanical! Wow! Super Mechanical is using his freezing ray to cool down Celia's drum. Let's try again. I can see a keen mechanical with his cone ready and waiting. Come on, Vicky! Now Celia's serving the ice cream to that queue of mechanicals. Let's get you back to the garage to get your generator fixed. Garage doors open at speed. It's time to help a vehicle in need. The mechanicals have all the parts to fix your generator, so you can get back to the beach and serve more ice cream later. Celia was very kind. She really loves to mix. But she should be with the construction crew. They've got a road to fix. Oh dear. Those vehicles do look grumpy. They've been waiting at the roadworks for ages. We're back. Thanks for helping Celia and Super Mechanical. Hooray. I think I'm finally going to get my ice cream. Wow! An ice cream from Celia and another one from Vicky. What a lucky gecko I am. Down on the construction site, Daisy the baby dumper truck is helping her Uncle Dylan. She's not very big, but she loves to help out. Oh no! Daisy's stuck in the mud! We need to help Daisy! Go, go, Tilly Tow Truck! Come on, Daisy. Let's go back to my garage and we'll take a look at your wheels. Something doesn't seem right with them. Garage doors open at speed. It's time to help a vehicle in need. Let's all see what we can learn as we make Daisy dumper truck turn. Those tires look awfully small, even for a baby truck. They look more like car tires to me. Tires have tread on the outside so they can grip the ground. Small tires have small grip, to keep our cars safe on the roads. But building sites are muddy and bumpy places, so construction trucks need big tyres with big grip. Okay, Daisy, let's get the mechanicals to swap your tyres for bigger ones. Go, go, mechanicals! Red and yellow are removing Baby's old, small car tyres. Green and blue are fetching some new, big construction truck tyres. Be careful there, Blue, that doesn't look safe. Uh-oh. Oh, Blue. You look very tired. Let's get these tyres fitted to Daisy. Good work, everyone! Those new big tyres have much thicker tread and much better grip. Our friend Max the Monster Truck is here at the stadium. He's practicing jumps and flips for his new super stunt show. Max wants to attempt a 360-degree backflip. It's one of the most difficult things a monster truck can do. To perform a perfect backflip and land back on his wheels again, Max needs to flip all the way over. Not 90 degrees. Not 180 degrees. Not 270 degrees. But a full 360 degrees. That's a full circle. Max is getting into position. I think he's ready. Three, two, one. Go, Max, go! 90 degrees? 180 degrees? 270 degrees? Oh, no! Oh, Max, you nearly made it. But you landed very hard on your front wheels. I think you might have broken something. Let's check your steering. Okay, Max. Try driving in a straight line. Oh dear. Now try turning left. Oh dear, oh dear. Now try turning right. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. That's not good. I think we need to get you to the garage right away. Hello, Tilly? Please, can you come over to the stadium right away? Max needs your help. Hello, Tilly. Are we glad to see you? Max's front wheels don't seem right. Could you tow him to the garage, please? And can you give me a lift back too? Garage doors open at speed. It's time to help a vehicle in need. Let's all see what we can learn as we make Max's turn. Max's jump didn't go well. That landing sure looked sore. I think his axle might be bent. Let's lift him to make sure. The axle connects to the wheels and helps Mac change direction. Just look at his wheels sag. He needs closer inspection. With a broken axle, Max can't jump. This really isn't great. I'll call on the mechanicals to get that axle straight. Go, go, mechanicals! There. Max is looking much better now. Well done, mechanicals. I think Max needs more power to complete his backflip without crashing again. I'll get the mechanicals to fit his engine with a turbocharger. The turbocharger fits onto Max's engine to make him more powerful so that he can go faster and jump further. Wow, listen to that! Sounds like Max is ready to try that jump again. Let's head back over to the stadium. Max is ready. 3, 2, 1, go! 90 degrees, 180 degrees, 270 degrees, 360 degrees, he's done it! A full backflip and a perfect landing. Well done, Max. I'm glad Max completed his amazing jump in the end, with a little help from his friends at Gecko's garage. These vehicles are helping Helen with her training exercises. It's important for Helen to practice lifting different vehicles and placing them down without hurting them, so that she can rescue vehicles in a real emergency. Helen's lifting each vehicle and placing them in a special order. Can you guess what the order is? That's right, she's sorting them by size. Starting from the left, we have the smallest vehicle first. Millie the motorbike, Rick the road roller, Max the monster truck, Rebecca the recycling truck, Fiona the fire truck, and... oh, there should be one more. Ah, here he is. Bobby the bus, just in time. Bobby's the biggest vehicle here. Helen, can you please lift Bobby to the end of the line? Oh dear, Helen. I think there's something wrong. Your winch cable looks like it's about to snap. Ah! Oh dear, oh dear. That wasn't supposed to happen. My arm is sore, but I'll be okay. Oh, Helen, you look badly hurt. I'll get Florence the forklift to lift you back up onto your skids, and we'll take a look at you. The skids are a helicopter's feet. Helen rests on them when she isn't flying. Your skids seem okay, but your rotors have been damaged. Your winch cable's snapped, and you're covered in scratches. This looks like a job for the mechanicals. Go, go, mechanicals! I'm really sorry, Helen. You're in such a sorry state. The mechanicals will fix you up, and you'll soon be feeling great. They'll swap your broken rotors, spray your scratches and much more. Fit a thicker cable to your winch, far, far stronger than before. Fantastic! Now you're all fixed up, let's head back outside and test your tough new winch out. Let's try sorting the vehicles by colours of the rainbow, starting with Fiona, the red fire truck on the left. Next is Max, the orange monster truck. Do you know who comes next? That's right, it's Rick, the yellow road roller. After Rick, it's Rebecca, the green recycling truck. Who's next? That's right, it's Millie, the blue motorbike. And last, but definitely not least, it's Bobby, the purple bus. Careful now, Helen. Nice and steady. Brilliant. The mechanicals have fixed you up and made your winch even stronger. You can lift Bobby up no problem. And now the vehicles form a perfect rainbow. And they match the real rainbow up in the sky. Beautiful! Bobby was supposed to be taking us back to the garage half an hour ago, but there's no sign of him. It's so cold today, and Blue Mechanical forgot to bring his hat, scarf and mittens. Oh no, there's Bobby. It looks like he's stuck in the snow. He can't get out of that snowdrift. And he looks very cold. That can't be good for his batteries. Just like us, Bobby the bus doesn't feel very well if he's too hot or too cold. His batteries work best when they are warm. Bobby's batteries can't give his wheels enough power when it's as cold as this, and his wheels don't have enough grip on the icy road. We need to help him right away. Come in, Tilly. I'm sending you Bobby's location now. Please, can you come and rescue him from a snowdrift? Make sure you put your snow chains on your tyres. The weather is terrible out here. Here comes trusty Tilly to ease poor Bobby's pains with her super grippy tyres and sturdy snow chains. She's so strong and steady, she doesn't make a fuss, even when she's towing a big electric bus. I don't think Blue Mechanical's feeling very well either. Hello, Tilly. Are we glad to see you? Let's head back to the garage to warm up. Garage doors open at speed. It's time to help a vehicle in need. Let's all see what we can learn as we make Bobby turn. Poor Bobby's wheels were really stuck. He couldn't make them go, and his batteries don't work so well under all that ice and snow. Now Tilly's brought him back here, out of the winter storm. We need those kind mechanicals to make poor Bobby warm. Go, go, mechanicals! I don't think that little hairdryer will melt this cold snow shower. I think we need something with a little bit more power. That heater's more like it. He'll soon be warm and dried. But how can we keep Bobby's batteries warm when he's back outside? Ah, when we go out into the cold, we wear a winter hat. So they're knitting one for Bobby. Why didn't I think of that? Bobby can stay with us for now to keep warm overnight. He can go out in the morning as soon as it gets light. Good old Trevor the tractor. He's spending the evening clearing the snow from the roads with his snow plough. The snow is melting. Trevor has helped to clear the roads. And Bobby has his new hat to keep him warm. He's off to do his job and pick up some passengers. I'm glad we could get Bobby warm again. Remember to always wear your coat, hat and gloves when you go outside in the winter. Just like me and the mechanicals. Hang on a minute. What happened to poor old Blue Mechanical? Ah, there he is. Phew! Bye! If you love this video, tap here so you're the first to know about my latest videos. Thanks for watching! Bye!